Hello and welcome back to the channel. In today's review, we're going to take a look at the first entry into the brand new Transformers Studio Series line. This line is a partnership between Takara Tomy and Hasbro, and it basically gives us a more updated figure of some of the previous characters throughout the five Transformers movies. This figure is based on Bumblebee's appearance in Transformers 2007 and gives us his look when he was in his old 77 Camaro look. As always, we're going to bring in the packaging and then we're going to take a look at the figure and the contents that comes inside. The packaging is very reminiscent of the Last Night Premiere Edition boxes, as well as some of the Star Wars The Black Series. We've got a very nice image of Bumblebee in his old retro form, Studio Series. He is number 01 in the line. To Hasbro and Takara Tomy, Generations Transformers. On the side of the box, we've got a very nice image of Bumblebee there. The back of the box just shows you the figure in both robot mode, vehicle mode. It says that he includes a backdrop and that he is scale, detailed and big screen inspired. We've got some of the others that are available in the line, Stinger, Crowbar and Ratchet. He's a fully licensed GM vehicle. And the other side of the box just says Studio Series 01 and a close up of Bumblebee's head. Overall, a very, very nice and very premium look for the packaging. Now, inside the box, you do get this cardboard display base. This is obviously based on the scene where this version of Bumblebee fights Barricade from the very first Transformers movie. It's just a corrugated cardboard piece with the very nice artwork printed. As you can see, it is that industrial warehouse that they were fighting in. It says Studio Series 01 Generations Transformers. And then the 2007 Transformers logo. The figure can be displayed on it, however, there's not much room, and due to Bumblebee's wings, you know, there's not really much play with the stand. Overall, a nice inclusion and definitely is something nice if you want to display your figures on them in your collection. Bringing the figure in himself in for a closer look, he is a heavy retooled in terms of engineering to that of the Last Night Deluxe Class Wave 3 Bumblebee, and he does definitely share some similarities in terms of molding. However, everything has been reduced in size and he actually has quite a few new pieces. So in a sense, this is a brand new figure that just reuses some of those transformation techniques. Bringing him in for a closer look, we can see that he has a very well done head sculpt. We've got a very nicely printed Autobot insignia on the top. We've got the split of the front car there, which looks really good. The forearms have been sculpted and the yellow paint has been applied throughout. Some very nice detailing in the chest section. As you can see, we've got the front grille, we've got the torso section, and we've got where the license plate would be. Would have been nice to have seen maybe a license plate sticker, seeing as they got the Autobot signia so precisely printed on there. The legs are very cool as well. We've got the shins, the feet, and the feet have actually been painted exceptionally well. We've got some silver paint, we've got the yellow band that goes around the end of the toe, like we should do. Turning the figure around on the back, I don't think it compresses as well as that Last Night Bumblebee, and I will be doing a comparison. I do think that this back section here should have compressed a little bit more. As you can see, we've got the four winged door pieces at the back. These are something that are relatively new on Bumblebee. I believe this is the third figure to actually have these, the first being the Masterpiece, the second being the Last Night version, and obviously the third being this version. So overall, for detail and paint applications, it's actually a very well done figure. Now, turning to articulation, it is very similar to that of the Wave 3, the Last Night Bumblebee. The head is on a ball joint, however, he has very limited upwards movement. However, he can look down a fair amount. The head can't really tilt side to side, but you can rotate it from left and right and hinge it down when you do so. The arms are on ball joints, so you can hinge those back and forth and out to the sides. There is a swivel at the upper bicep, just above where the elbow section is, and a 90 degree bend at the elbow. There's also some hand articulation, however, that's mainly due to transformation. He does have a 360 degree waist articulation joint, however, due to the back kibble, it does hinder and restrict some pieces. The legs, people have complained that the joints are extremely loose. Mine are actually fairly tight straight out of the packaging, so I don't know whether this is a running change version. This is the UK version, it had the EU stamps on the packaging, so perhaps that they have managed to do some retooling and just adjust the mold slightly. The legs kick forwards and backwards as well as up to the sides. there is a rotation at the upper thigh and about a near enough 90 degree bend at the knee. The feet are on pivot joints so they can hinge forwards and backwards. However, you will disengage the transformation joint if you are not careful. So overall for articulation on a deluxe class figure, yet again, it's very, very well done. Now turning to accessories, Bumblebee does come with one, that being his fusion cannon or his stinger blaster. As you can see, it has been detailed and painted fairly well. We've got a very nice silver paint all around the cannon with the yellow shield in a yellow plastic and then silver picked out in the center. It's fairly basic and is what we've come to expect from Bumblebee's weapon. In order to integrate it into the figure, it is slightly easier than that Last Knight version. This time, you just simply slide off the arm and then plug this one on. And it just goes on so much easier and less force is required than that the Last Knight version. Storage for either the ion blaster or the hand. There's just little ports on both of them. This one's the yellow port. This one's a little grey nub. They just plug directly into this back piece here. He has a little hole right at the back. They just plug there for storage. However, it does look a bit dumb, but it doesn't get away. It doesn't get in the way of articulation and is a nice inclusion on this figure. Now, on the left of the screen, I have the brand new Studio Series Bumblebee, and on the right of the screen, I have the Last Knight version. As you can see, there is a considerable difference in terms of the scaling. The Last Knight version is a lot bigger than the Studio Series version. I do believe that these studio figures are supposed to be in scale with one another, so that's probably why they've decided to scale Bumblebee down as much as they have. But for those who are saying that this is a direct retool of this version, you are wrong. This is different in many, many aspects. All parts of this figure that are carried over from this figure are either scaled down or completely remolded. So in a sense, this is a brand new figure that just really shares a lot of the engineering aspects from this Bumblebee. For another size comparison, here is Bumblebee next to his Wavemate Ratchet. As you can see, Ratchet is still a deluxe class, but is considerably larger than Bumblebee. However, I don't even think the scale necessarily really works here. I think Ratchet should definitely be a Voyager. However, it is nice to see Ratchet being slightly taller than Bumblebee. Now, I believe that just about wraps it up for the robot mode. I'm not going to show you the transformation on this guy, as I am fairly late reviewing these due to there being a limitation to the UK distributors. So I will just be jumping straight from the robot mode into the vehicle mode. If you do wish to see a transformation segment, check out some of the other reviewers. They do go into more details on how to transform him. So we're gonna go from Bumblebee looking like this. And now here we have Bumblebee in what I believe is his 1977 Camaro mode. As you can see, it is a dead ringer for that vehicle that we saw at the beginning of the first live action Transformers movie. And I think it's been replicated extremely well, actually. The Camaro is very slick looking, and it's very classic looking as well, which is definitely the look that I believe the producers and the car scouts were going for the very first iteration of Bumblebee. Vehicle mode also has quite a few nice paint applications. We've got the red painted tail lights at the back with a silver bracket. We've got all that classic Bumblebee striping along the hood and on the rear section. Got the turquoise blue painted headlights with the silver brackets again, as well as the front grille piece. And the tires are actually painted black for the tires, and then the rims are just in a gray plastic. The doors are also painted in yellow to help keep the translucent plastic. However, I would have just preferred it if this was all blacked out and then they had painted the yellow. I'm not really a big fan of clear plastic on Transformers, especially as you can see all the bits inside. Overall, a very well nicely replicated vehicle mode. Now, this obviously does have weapon storage. You can take the gun. There is a little slot there and there that these two ports will plug into. They just peg in like so. However, it is quite dumb looking. He does just have it hanging out of his back, and it does split the back section up. So just give that a press and it will stay tightly together. Nice inclusion, however, not necessarily something that I will be displaying on the vehicle mode. For a comparison, I thought it'd be cool to see what the 1977 Camaro looks like next to the 67 Camaro. This was obviously Bumblebee from Age of Extinction. As you can see, the new Bumblebee is near enough the same size as the High Octane Bumblebee from AOE. However, you know, you can notice, especially when they're down, that the Age of Extinction version is a taller vehicle. However, these are not meant to be in scale with one another. This is supposed to scale with others in the line. So it's a reasonably sized deluxe class vehicle mode. Overall, I'm fairly impressed with the first entry to this brand new Studio Series line. I'm very lucky in the fact that I don't have loose joints, I don't have parts popping off. So maybe that's just my version and I was lucky to get one with more tolerance. But the robot mode as well as the vehicle mode are extremely accurate to what we saw from that very first Transformers movie. And it's definitely nice to see an updated version on such an old design. I also do like the inclusion of the backdrop, however not necessary, it is still cool to have. And the paint applications are pretty decent in both modes. I do recommend this if you never picked up the original 77 version, or if you just like collecting Transformers movie figures, then you'll definitely like this. However, please be aware that you may get one that doesn't have as good tolerance as mine, as there have been reports of some that have parts popping off, as well as extremely loose joints. Hope this review was informative. If it was, please let me know down in the comment section below, and I'll see you next time in my next Transformers review.